Hi friends, this is Prashant. Today we are going to start with introduction to standard 9th. Now which quantities, physical quantities we are dealing in this 9th and 10th standard, that parts are very important. Now this is our first lecture for standard 9th. Now we'll start with what do you mean by first, what are physical quantities. Now what are physical quantity? The quantity which are all the quantity which you can measure, or all measurable quantities, are called physical quantities, like mass, length, time, temperature, amount of substance. All these are called physical quantities. Now the definition is the quantity which you can measure, they are called physical quantities. Now basically these physical quantities, we'll divide this into two parts. One is a vectors and second is a scalar. Now what are scalars and what are vectors? The physical quantity which can be completely expressed by its magnitude only, they are called as scalar quantities. The quantity which can be completely expressed by its magnitude only, they are called scalars. And the physical quantity which require both magnitude and direction, they are called vectors. So scalars require only magnitude. Now what is magnitude? Magnitude is a numerical value. It has numerical value. Say force is 10 newton, so 10 newton is a magnitude. But vectors required both magnitude and direction. And what direction? They are called as vector quantity. Now if I say mass, it is 10 kg, but if I say force, it is 10 newton. So in force, I need to specify what is the direction. It is towards east, towards west, upward, downward. That is what is called as a vector quantity. Now we'll go with next physical quantities, which are related to in this chapter. Now next part is the, we'll go with what is the difference between distance and displacement. Now displacement is a vector and distance is a scalar. Now check, what is the distance? Suppose this is point A, this is point B. Say I stay at Borivali and say you stay at Kandivali. The distance between these two is say 4 km. Now in first case, I am starting from Borivali going to Kandivali. So my distance and displacement both will be about 4 km. This is also 4 km. Now second case, if I am going from Borivali to Kandivali and again coming back to Borivali, so my displacement will be 0, but distance will be 8 km. Now what is displacement? It is the shortest distance between the starting point and the end point. That is called as what? Displacement. And the actual path covered is called as what? Distance. Now you take an example of uniform circular motion. This is the body performing uniform circular motion. This is the origin. This is radius r. Body started from here and again coming back to the same point. So my distance covered is equal to circumference, which is equal to 2 pi r, which is called as what? Circumference, which is equal to 2 pi r. R is radius, which is distance. And displacement will be 0 because my starting point and end point is same. Now this is one part. If I go to half circle, that is half circle. Now over here, this is the center O, this is point A, this is point B. Can I say this is radius, right? So particle is started from here and again coming back to point B. So my distance covered is 2 pi r upon 2, that is equal to pi r. And my displacement will be 2 r. Displacement will be what? 2 r. That is the difference between distance and displacement. Now we'll go with the next example. In next example, we'll go with Pythagoras theorem. Now suppose there are three points. So this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. Now this is at 90 degrees. Say this distance covered is say 3 km. This is 4 km. So this AC is what? 5 km. A person is started from here, is going towards B. Right, distance covered is 3 km. Then at 90 degrees is moving towards C and he covered 4 km distance. So starting was A and end, terminus is point C. So what is distance covered? Distance covered will be 7 km, but displacement will be what? 5 km. That is the shortest distance between starting point and end point. This is about the distance and displacement. Now the next part is about what you mean by speed. What do you mean by velocity? So if I say speed, speed is nothing but what? Distance upon time. So SI unit will be meter per second. If I say velocity, the velocity will be what? Displacement upon what? Time. Again SI unit will be meter per second, but speed is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. Now the next part is about what do you mean by acceleration. Now what is acceleration? Acceleration is denoted by letter A, small a. So what is acceleration? It is the rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. When they say rate, that means it is divided by time. So write here acceleration is equal to V minus U upon T. This is the formula. Where what is U? Is called initial velocity, right? V is called as final velocity and T is the time. T is what? Time. Now what will be SI unit for acceleration? So SI unit will be, it is meter per second upon time, that is second. So this is meter per second square will be the acceleration, right? Now there are various cases. Now if your final velocity is greater than initial, then acceleration is positive. Acceleration is what? Positive. But if your final velocity is less than initial, then your acceleration is what? Negative. Now this negative acceleration is also called as retardation. It is also called as what? Retardation. It is negative acceleration is retardation. Now we'll go with the next part. Acha, what are the example of acceleration and retardation? So acceleration is what? Suppose your car is at rest. When you start your car, you are accelerating your car, right? Now when your car is already in motion, and if you apply brakes or you stop your car or you reduce your speed, then that is called as what? Retardation. Increasing speed or velocity is called as acceleration, and reducing speed or velocity is called as what? Retardation, right? Okay, now the next term is about momentum. It is called as what? Linear momentum. I will use word, it is linear momentum. Linear momentum is denoted by letter small p. Now what is momentum? Momentum is a product of mass and velocity. If the body is at rest, then momentum will be zero. But as soon as you apply force, that body will be in motion. So there is a relation between force and momentum. There is a relation between force and momentum. So why I'm calling linear momentum? Because there are two types of motion. One is linear motion and second will be angular motion. Rotation of a fan is an angular motion. Body moving in a straight line is a linear motion. There is a difference, right? Now check. Linear momentum P is the product of what? Mass and velocity. So its SI unit is mass is kilogram, velocity is what? Meter per second. Mass is what? Kg. Velocity will be meter per second. So it is kilogram meter per second is the linear momentum. Now next part, how linear momentum and force are related. So right here, according to Newton's second law, we have force is equal to m into a, because you got F is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum. It is called as what? Rate of change of momentum. We'll do this part in the next chapter, not here. So from that we get F is equal to M. Now, what is F? Force. Force is that physical quantity which change either state of body means if the body is at rest, it will be in motion. If the body is already in motion, it will either stop or it will move in opposite direction. That depends upon what is the magnitude and direction of force. Now, next part is about what is the effect of force. So if you apply force on a body, that body may get deformed. Means there will be either change in shape or size or both shape and size of a body. That is what is the force. Now over here, force SI unit will be kilogram meter per second square. This entire quantity is called as Newton. But if it is written in word, it is n small, it is Newton, right? Now how they are related to CGS? So 1 Newton is equal to 1 kg into 1 meter per second square. Now 1 kg, kg is 10 raised to 3 gram. 1 meter is 10 raised to 2 centimeter per second square. That comes out to be 10 raised to 5 gram centimeter second raised to minus 2, which is 10 raised to 5 dyne. So 1 Newton is equal to what? 10 raised to 5 dyne. This is one relation. Now, next part is about what is work, right? This you got the relation between force is assigned CGS unit. I will have this part. Now we'll go with the next part. What is work? Now, work is the product of force and displacement. Work done depends on two factors. One is force and second is displacement. Now, what will be SI unit? This is force ka kya rahega Newton, displacement is in meter. This Newton meter is written as what? Joule. Joule agar word rahega, to J small, it is joule. Right? This is one part. Then there is a term called as moment of force. Now moment of force is also called as torque. Now what is torque? Torque is nothing but turning effect of a body about the given axis of rotation. Now check, this is our door. These are the hinges. This is your axis of rotation about which we are turning this door. So these are the hinges, first, second and third. Here is your handle, right? I want to open this door, so I will pull. I want to close this door, this is push. So this is the force and the perpendicular distance between them is what? D. So moment of force or torque is equal to, it is a product of force into perpendicular distance. Again over here, SI unit will be Newton into meter, that is Newton meter. But this Newton meter, you cannot write as joule. Here you can write joule, but here you cannot write joule. Why? Because moment of force is a vector quantity. It is which quantity? Vector. But your work is a scalar quantity. That is the difference. This is your 10 standard concept. It is 10 standard concept. Okay. Now we'll go with the next part. Now what is the next part? Next part is the what do you mean by thrust? Next part is what? What do you mean by thrust? Now thrust is nothing but it is a force acting normally. Force acting normally is called as thrust. Now thrust is a kind of force only. Now what is the example? I'm standing here. My weight is acting vertically downward. So what I am applying is the thrust. Right? Now I'm pushing this wall, but if I push this wall normal, perpendicular to this surface, it is called as normal force. But if I make some angle with this wall, then it is not called as normal force. So thrust is a kind of force only. So this is the surface on which if I apply force 90 degree to this surface, it is called as what? Thrust. Next part is what? Pressure. Now what is pressure? It is nothing but thrust upon area. That is called pressure. The thrust is nothing but force upon what area? The force ka SI unit is Newton per meter square. It is written as Newton meter raised to minus 2. That is also called as Pascal, right? If the, it is word in Pascal PE. Now, next part. Next part is what? It is the pressure. Now, pressure is done. Okay, next will be power. What is power? It is work upon time. Power will be what? Work upon time. Work is W, time is T, right? So what will be SI unit for power? It is joule per second, which is called as what? Watt. Word may rahega to W, A, double T, watt, right? This is the power. Now there is one relation how power is related to force and velocity, that is there in 10th standard. Now check, this is very small point. We have power is equal to work upon time. Work can be written as force into displacement upon time. But what is displacement upon time? It is velocity. So right here, power is equal to force into velocity. So they can give SI unit of power as also Newton meter per second. Because same as what? Watt. Newton meter per second is what? Watt. Right? Now we'll go with the next part. Now there's a next part is what? We'll discuss that remaining part in the coming lectures. Thank you so much.